Residents of Dolre Island who have appealed to the government to extend health services as the only health facility in the area lacks equipment, beds, diagnosis machines, a boat ambulance, among others. COVID-19 at the island is at 32%, but the facility has no wards, and positive cases are admitted under a tree where they live day and night. We have the report.
Dolre is one of the largest islands in Namayingo district, and it's at the border of Uganda and Kenya. The island is densely populated with numerous challenges in the health sector. Dolre Health Center 3 is the only health facility that serves the island and others adjacent to it. At out-of-patient department, the record shows a number of between 70 to 100 patients that do visit the facility seeking for medical services on a daily basis. However, the situation at the health center is alarming. There's not even a single bed, meaning patients on admission do receive treatment at the floor. The health facility is understaffed with no drugs, water supply, and all essential equipments used in patients' diagnosis are lacking.
Tetulina bitanda woba olwadde bakutera wansi omufaliso n'olyoka n'okola ki n'obeerako ensonga ey'okubiri kyetaagisa abasawo
twala eddagala temuli malwaliro abasawo batono.
The facility in charge, Daniel Ochan, says that they are challenged with referrals of patients who need further management as they don't have a boat ambulance to vessel out patients to the mainland. He says that this has led to loss of many lives with the recent happening yesterday.
An ambulance that operates from the island to the landing site on the mainland. And from the mainland, connecting to the health facility on the land. So that referral system is cut off. Therefore, it means that most of the emergencies we may not be able to handle effectively as expected. In case of such emergency referrals, the locals mobilize funds amongst themselves and then they see a way of referral. However, in some instances where they cannot afford, of course that patient has to die.
The situation at the facility has disheartened the Parliament Select Committee on COVID-19. With the highest rates of COVID-19 cases in the district standing at 32%, Dolre Health Center 3 has no isolation wards for patients, and patients are admitted under a tree shed 24 hours where they receive treatment from.
The positivity rate here is 32%. Now, when you look at that tree, under that tree, that is where, that is the isolation center where our people are kept. Yesterday, we lost a Ugandan here because they failed to manage here. You have seen inside the rooms, our people are lying on the floor in this era, not in this time. This is not Stone Age time. We really want to appeal to government to get a little more serious. This is a very big crisis.
Anyway, many, many mothers have lost their lives during the time of delivery. Because by the time the mother reaches the mainland, she's already tired, and in the end, we always lose a mother and even the baby. So it is very common that whenever there is an issue of referral, that nearly 3 out of 10 mothers are lost.
The district health officer, Dr. Stephen Mangeni, attributed escalating COVID-19 positive cases porous borders within the district.
The edge of our district is actually worse off in the islands in terms of positivity rate. So right now, Lolwe Islands, where we are coming from, the positivity rate is at 32%. And Sigulu is at 30%. And in Namayingo as a district, we are at 29%. So yet the national positivity by yesterday was at 6%. That communicates that Namayingo, we are actually worse off, and the situation is not as good. But it's also now clear to us that the problem is much more when from the island population.
He is also against the Ministry of Health directive of having VHTs manage COVID cases in communities as they don't have specialty. Dr. Emmanuel Otara, the chairperson of the committee, assured the community of a positive response to the concerns raised.
We've also identified problems, especially relating to lack of the necessary equipment and protective gear, and as a task force, we are going to immediately call upon the Ministry of Health to rush here with the necessary personal protective equipment, but also to provide the necessary beds as an immediate measure to address the problem of the pandemic in this part of the country.
Story by Ivan Lubega for the News.